Entrance of your word, give you light and give you an understanding to the simple. Father, we surrender everything unto you. Father, as your word comes for this morning, Father, we pray that your word will set us free, because you send your word and your word deliver them. And your word will set us free this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you will draw us closer to you, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, from today, O Lord, Father, you will open our spiritual eyes, O Lord. Father, Lord, we will change our ways, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. To move closer to you, Lord, Father, we need your help. We cannot do it alone, O Lord. Holy Spirit, come and dwell within us. Help us, O Lord, to walk in your way, O Lord. Father, Lord, we will not depart from your presence, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have worship. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Happy Sunday to every one of us. And happy birthday to our church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to thank God for the man of God that preached last week, Pastor YG. The message was stand up and stand out. For you to stand up and stand out, you have to separate yourself from the crowd. The topic of my message today is separate yourself from the crowd. As a Christian, we know that we are often required to do things differently to everyone else. In fact, we are specifically instructed not to conform to this way of the world. In Romans 12, chapter 2, Romans 12, 2, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your heart, that you may prove what is good and acceptable in the perfect will of God. If you look at what is going on in the world today, we don't know the difference between Christian and not Christian. What the unbelievers are dying for, the same Christians are dying for it. We don't know the difference. When you see believer, you see unbeliever, you don't know the difference. The dressing, the way we talk, the way we do things, we don't see the difference between believer and not believer these days. So many things have occupied our mind. We are so committed to the social media. Social media is the one that is giving us the instruction what to do. The fear of God is no more in us. When you look at social media, so many things that we see, general overseer, pastors, doing rituals. Now the assassins are going to the church to kill man of God. And we are asleep. In the book of Matthew 13:25, it says, but when the man slept, his enemy came and sowed tears among them. There is so much hatred in the body of Christ. Pastors are know that they are keeping malice to each other. It's about time for us to wake up. Stand up and stand out. Separate yourself from the crowd. God is not looking for the crowd. As a Christian, we need to find our route back. In the book of Proverbs 14:12, there is a way that appears to be right, but at the end is dead. We are not of this world. We need to change the way you dress, change the way you talk. People don't fear God anymore. You will see people running around all the altar, doing so many manner of things. There's no more respect for God. People on Instagram are the ones that are telling you not to pay your tithe, and you will not pay your tithe. You will see Christians crying because you want to buy Brazilian hair. You use your tithe to go and buy what's the name? The new shoe that the new ladies are wearing now. Eh? What's the name of that shoe? There's that Lilia. What is the name of that your shoe? There's a name they call it now. I'm not really. You don't know? Okay. They will use their money to go and buy that kind of shoe. Your tithe. And when you go to party and you broke your leg, you say it's the devil. It's not the devil. Because you don't use the right money to buy the shoe. There's nothing wrong when you buy that shoe. There's nothing wrong in it. It's your money, you work for it. You have to enjoy your life. You see, pastor kidnapping himself. Yes, in Ondo State, a man of God, after he spent the church money, he's looking for a way to refund the money back. He kidnapped himself. He went to the hotel, called the church that he had been kidnapped by the Fulani henchmen. Now the judge, they get panicked. They need 3 million to bail him out. So they report to the police. Police started tracing the number. They find out the man is in the hotel. And they say it's the work of the devil. We're asleep, and the enemy have sowed tears in the body of Christ. You may not be aware of it. But it's about time for us to wake up. If the foundation may be destroyed, what can the righteous do? The righteous have to wake up and go back to God. It's about time for us to go back to God. Separate yourself from the crowd. Brethren, it's about time for us to wake up. Things are not going right in the body of Christ. Especially we Pentecostal. We are so spiritual more than anybody. Pentecostal is the one that doesn't want to have anything to do with any white man garment people. Celestia don't go with Kerubu. Kerubu doesn't work with Anglican. Anglican doesn't work with Methodist. And we say we are the same body of Christ. If someone invites you now and say, come to my church, which church? Ah, Celestia. No, I can't come to Celestia. But you want to invite them to come to your church. They give you food you will not eat. You keep malice. Too many amebo. Lie pastors. Lord, you know, they lie too much. The money that we're supposed to invest in the life of our member, you will go and take that money and invite some comedian to come and make people laugh. They spend million inviting comedians. People that you don't know about their spiritual life, they come to the altar of God. Maybe they don't drink NSE and they want to make you laugh. After you make you laugh, when you get back home, you get that dick. Oh, God said, draw closer to me and I will draw near to you. If you're far away from me, it will be far away from you. The more attention we pay to the word of God, the less tension we have in our life. The more you pay attention to the word of God, you have less tension. Nothing will make you get panic. It's about for us to wake up. Some people come to church. They don't belong to any ministry, but they are the CNN of the church. Anything going on in the church, before the service finish, people that doesn't even come to church, they already know what is going on. And they will go there and lie and say, Pastor was talking about your family. Pastor was preaching about your family. People fear men than fear God. People fear IRS than fear God. They fear coronavirus. The Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run to it and they were saved. But during coronavirus, the case is not like that. The righteous run away. They don't come to church. Some people are still at home now, going to 2 years, running away from coronavirus. Instead of them to run into the church, they run to Costco, Sam's Club, Walmart. What are they looking for? Biscuits. They still get the coronavirus. You say you are running away from church because you don't want to get coronavirus, and you are running to Costco. You will see them line up. Sam's Club. They will say, Sam's Club, we open 12 o'clock. You are there since 6 a.m. But they told you to come to church 8 a.m. You say, I can't wake up early. Believer. Spirit feed. Especially with Pentecostal. We are so spiritual. Hallelujah. We speak in tongues like more than the angels. We condemn people. You have some special people that you talk to. There are some people that you don't talk to. Where are we going? Where is the body of Christ is going? During the worship, you see people moving around. Instead of them to worship God, they are moving around. Walking through and through. People come to church. You sit down inside the church like you are in your living room. You put one leg on the another chair. See, some people come to church. They didn't listen to message. They are watching movie on their phone, on their iPad. Social media have already messed up a lot of things. People watch porno inside the church. There is a church in Nigeria, they were doing innovation. By the time they opened, they take the pulpit. It was full of condom. It's not CVS, it's not Walgreens. By the time they begin to dig in, they know that pastor and choir mistress, they were going out together. There is no more fear of God. No more fear of God. Go to social media. Every day you will see something they talk about pastor. This morning, I opened my Facebook. Is a member stab his pastor at the back. No, people don't give honor to pastors anymore because a lot of pastors run to the ministry because of money. It's not because of the work of God. Jesus fed 5,000 people. Immediately he filled them. He told his disciple, let's go to the other side. If it's nowadays, this is a church. Let's open the church here. 5,000, we're going to make money from these people. Church will organize a seminar. They have organized program. And they will not think about how they're going to fill their men, people that are coming. Ordinary bottle of water, they will not even give them. But you want the money from their pocket. They will go home without anything inside them. And you will still be preaching. You need to wait for grace. If you go home without the grace, it's not good. You want to kill them? Do you make a provision for them? Do you give them food? He said, Jesus, have compassion on people. I don't want these people. They've been staying with us for 3 days. They cannot just go. Let's find something to feed them. He feed them to the extent that they're barely full. They have extra basket. Children of God, it's about for us to wake up. This is just a wake-up call. I was trying to find another message that will be sweet, that people will like. But I keep struggling in my spirit until last week when Pastor IG was saying, stand up and stand out. That was what confirmed this message. And said, God said, we should have to separate ourselves from the crowd. We need to pay more attention to the word of God. There are some people now, they are home. Doing what? Watching BB Ninja. I was told that all those things that they do in BB Ninja was... It's not something that a number one man is supposed to be watching that kind of program. I heard that I seen last week Sunday. Is it about first Sunday of this month? It's on YouTube. They went to church and killed an assistant pastor in the middle of service. And we are here, we say everything is fine. All is well. Believers are so stingy, they cannot give from anything out. People will come to you for help. Financial help, you will tell them you don't have. But when that person died, you will be the first person to say, I give 200, I give 500. It's not about the house that you build. It's not about how many children that you have. It's about how many people you bless when you are alive. We need to change. The only people you talk to is the people that go to Pentecostal church. Only people that go to Redeem. If you see another one that go to Christ Embassy, no. You see, the name of their church is Christ Embassy. There is no Christ Embassy. There is no Redeem in heaven. You see, worker, the same people that you were together for years, the moment they say, I'm not coming to church anymore, when you call them, they will not even pick up your phone. And you call yourself a believer, spirit feed. You still speak in tongues. Speaking in tongues doesn't mean you are still in the on the right track. We need to draw closer to God so that He can draw closer to us. The book of Psalm 1 verse 1 says, Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of the sinner, nor seated in the seat of the scriptful. But his delight is in the Lord of the Lord. His law does he meditate day and night. Do you meditate on the word of God day and night? Do you? This is not the kind of message that people like to hear. The kind of message we like to hear is receive it, cash it, and ship it. We come to church, only immediately you feel you want to run away. You don't belong to any ministry. Your own ministry is rocking chair ministry. You just put usher you to the chair. You rock the chair. After 3 hours, you go home. You already finished rocking the chair. Your own is Babylon just to come, the blogger, to come and take anything, whatever that is going on in the church. Go and tell them outside. You see all those bloggers? 95% of them, they are church members before they start their own blogger. And they will be using their pastor. Talking about their pastor, pulling down their pastor. You see pastor fighting against pastor, trying to put down pastor. If any church come here now and move to another church at our back now, a lot of people want to go and fight the city. Why do you give them license? Is it not the same body of Christ? Instead of us to go there and say, do you guys need anything that we can support you? I heard a testimony of one church in Nigeria. They were building the church, and the Muslim people saw that the church is not really moving fine. They went and go and buy a truck of cement and give to the church, Muslim, to build the church. When the Christian will say, now, this church, no. That church has to be closed. People in the same ministry, they will not talk to each other, keeping malice. And you say you want to make heaven. You want to make heaven. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 33. Do not be deceived. Evil communication corrupt good manners. Don't deceive yourself. The more you are seen in the world, they will corrupt your manners. Cry about, I want to buy Brazilian head. I must buy Brazilian head. I want to tread too. Keep treading. The kind of Christian we have these days is microwave Christian, Indomie Christian. All the song you hear in the church, we don't sing that thing anymore. Oh, Baba, thing I used to say, I say there no more. Oh, Baba, friend, I used to have, I have them no more. Oh, Baba, things I used to do, I do them no more. There is a great change to serve my God. There is a great change to serve my God. Great change to serve my God. Great change to serve my God. There is a great change to serve my God. Thank you for saving me. Thank you, my Lord. Thank you for saving me. Thank you, my Lord. All those songs, we don't sing it anymore. The song in church now is Bama Jesuniwo. Teshumale. Keep Teshumale. It's not a Naramari that we sing inside the church now. All those youths now. Bama Jesuniwo. Yeah, Bese Kato Sumale. Yeah, Teshumale. Oh, yeah, Bese. Keep Bese. When the devil will deal with you, you will know where you are going to. You need to move closer to God. Let's change our ways. Enemy has sowed tears. Why can you be fighting your own brother inside your church? I don't talk to him. He's not from my tribe. You only talk to people that come from your tribe. During this time, you see people staying outside, receiving call. Some of us will be on prayer line. The moment you see a call, this call is a big call, business call, you will cut off the call. God doesn't really matter to you. You want to answer business call first. God understand now, this part of breakthrough. This is what I've been praying for. God answer my prayer. The call just coming. You cut off prayer line because of business. People in the world, they know how to sacrifice. When they are abalist people to them, you 12 o'clock, you will not sleep. You have to make incantation, you have to do this. You will see them. We watch movie. They will put their leg inside water. Eating cola nut. They will tell you to pray. God understand now. I just came back from work. God understand. We need to separate ourselves. Separate yourself from the crowd. Book of Proverbs chapter 1 verse 15. My son, walk not thou in the way of them. Refer their food from their path. She should not walk in their way. The unbeliever is supposed to be the one to want to live the kind of life you are living. But you are the one that is one you want to live the kind of life you are living. There are some of us now, if we come to your house now, if you open your fridge, Holy Ghost, we see NSC. When they ask you now, they say, it's a blood tonic. Keep drinking your blood tonic. No problem. No problem. Brethren, we need to check ourselves. Social media have taken a lot of draw us back from the presence of God. So many things is happening in the body of Christ. Pastor hiring higher that has seen to go and kill his own fellow pastor. When they get arrested, they say, why is it? Because he has more members than his ministry. A pastor went to a brother and said, my church is not growing. The guy took the man to a abalis. God drew a world. The church began to flow. Everybody, people believed it was anointing. Then the brother went to the pastor and said, hey, where's our agreement? You haven't paid me. The pastor refused to pay. The guy hired another sin. The day they will kill the pastor, the choir mistress was in the house of the pastor, the secretary was in the house of the pastor, and they killed three of them. People that doesn't even know anything about it. When he arrested him, he said, it's my friend. This is our agreement, but he didn't pay me, so that's why I killed him. Where are we going to? People are in the haste to make money. They want to become a rich person fast. 17, 18 years, they will say they have suffered. At the age of 17, you have suffered. Singles, you have to be very careful. Get closer to God. Don't let that one brother go and take the life of flower and give it to you. And say, this is a rose. Take. I say, oh my God, very cute. When you get what he's looking for, he will abandon you. Now, lie. Luriro, they're just lying to you. They will just deceive you. You're supposed to be on fire, but they are not on fire. They are carrying ice block. Pure water. Ice block, pure water. That's what they are carrying now. They're supposed to be on fire. But when they come to church, you're on fire! Where's your fire? After church, you go take your ice block back. Don't let any man, any boy deceive you. They go buy $1, they go to 99 and go buy $1 flower and give it to you. And say, you are so nice. Deceive yourself. We need to move closer to God. Separate ourselves from the world. Let's separate ourselves. Stand up and stand out. That is what the word of God said. The world will hate you. People will hate you. They will not like you. If you read the book of John 15 from 18 to 19, they will hate you. They hate Jesus too. In Mark 14, 32 to 41, when Jesus called his disciple to pray, not all his disciples, just take three out of 12. Say, let's go and pray. Or they went there, they did not pray. They were sleeping. Jesus came the first time, they were sleeping. Second time, they were sleeping. The third time, they were snoring. He said, their eyes was heavy. There are so many believers. Our eyes is heavy. We sleep. Monday to Friday, you don't call him. In the evening, you don't call him. Sunday morning, you don't call him. But when they call you for overtime, you are ready to go. Let's change our ways. Worker that you cannot discipline. Are you a worker? Usher cannot tell you where to sit. You already have a special place where you sit anytime you come to church. Humble yourself. We need to humble ourselves. Many people are still home now, going to 2 years because of coronavirus. You see kids, they will be running around the altar, playing with the pulpit, when they tell their parents, oh, they are just kids. They are just kids. You know, they don't know anything. But if they want any medical person come here now and say, this pulpit is full of virus. If you touch, you have virus. See the parent when the child is running to that pulpit. Hey, Allah Koba, don't cover me. You don't know there is virus on that pulpit. They will run away, but you don't respect God. We don't respect God. When they say something is utter of God, you have to give respect. When your kid is running today, you call them back. That place is no go area. You let them know. When they started growing up, they will know that. When they grow up, they know that the pulpit, the altar of God, is the special place. Medical people say, cover your nose, wash your hand, use your face mask. Everybody is putting their face mask. But God said, do not commit adultery. You say, oh, I don't want to concern you. Now my life now. It's not your life. You borrow it. When the owner comes, you're gone. The owner can come at any time. There are some people that say, especially youth. It's my life. They will be telling their parents. It's my life. I'm 18. I can live my life the way I want to live it. Deceive yourself. It's not your life. It's borrowed. My own life is borrowed. Your own life is borrowed. When the owner comes, you don't have an excuse. Millions of people died last year of coronavirus. Why did not tell coronavirus, so it's my life. I can't die now. Especially youth. I don't know what's wrong with our youth. See, honor your father and your mother so that your day be long. No, you don't want to honor them. Say, it's my life. I can live my life the way I want to live it. I'm just letting you know now. It's not your life. You don't have life. Oh. The owner can come at any time. It's not about age. People die every day. Go to ICU, you see people on life support. As we are talking right now, some people's body they are carrying that body to mortuary now. They cannot tell the devil and say, it's my life. I can live my life. Like one of the celebrity Nigeria sing one song. It's my life. Oh, I can live my life. Oh, keep living your life. When the death comes, you will know. You sing the song to the devil. Until you find yourself inside the grave, you know it's not your life. Let's change our ways. Change your ways. If there's something that you are not doing right, change. Somebody tell your neighbor and says, change. I have my own that I know that the way that this way is not the way of God. I need to change. I'm working on it. Don't think you are holy than anybody. Pentecostal people, children of God, Redeemer, you need to change. Don't look at other Christians and say, they are not holy than you. When they come to you for help, help them if you can. It's not only your family you help. It's not only your family. Let's open our Bible to the book of Hebrews. Hebrews 13. Let the brotherly love continue. Be not forgive grateful to this entertain stranger. You say we should entertain stranger. Whether you know that person or not, help them when they come to you. Don't look at people that are homeless and say they did it's because of drugs. Many of them is not because of drug. Some of them lost their job. Some of them, maybe their driving license, you suspend their driving license, you can't do anything. They become homeless. You look at everybody and say, hey, this is homeless. I work for my money, I work hard. No. It's God that gives you that strength. Thank God that someone comes to you for help. Especially we Pentecostal, we need to change our ways when it comes to giving. Apart from being stingy to people, we are stingy to God. You cannot even give God money. How many of us, you say, you come to church one Sunday and say, you give 1,000. It's not special offering, you just want to give offering, 1,000. Raise up your hands. You come to church. It's not special offering. It's not that you are looking for something. Just say, I come to church. I want to give offering. I give 1,000. People will celebrate birthday. They will go and rent all. Pay 25,000, 20,000 to rent all. Call the musician to come and play for them. Cook food. They will spend close to 50,000 on birthday. And they will tell the church, we are coming, we're coming next week Sunday to come and do Thanksgiving. Thank you for saving me. Thank you, my Lord. Thank you for saving me. Thank you. By the time they drop the envelope, all the $1 that they spray them at the party, they put it in the envelope. There are some $1 that when you take it to bank, machine will reject the money. You bring it to God and just thank you for saving me. Someone that saved you is $1 you have to give him. We need to change our ways. People are more important than God. How can you rent a hall for 25,000? You cannot give God 1,000. Not even new note. Some people will come and put offering that already tears into two. I work in finance department. And the King Kong can bear my weakness. Sometimes we were looking for sellotape to put it together. Tear money, you come and give it to God. But when you go to party, you want people to see you that, yeah, you have arrived. Bring new notes. You spray new notes on the celebrant. But you come to Church of God, dirty one. You just put it here. Let them go and do this. It's not the church. After all, it's minister that are spending the money. Minister is not spending your money, especially in this church. No minister get paid. Even our pastor doesn't get paid. That's why we say when you pay tithe, if you want to see the record, come to finance department. We open the office for you. You look at your money. How we spend your money, you see there. No minister here can come out and say, hey, they pay me $1. Or pastor will say, hey, I'm getting $1 for the work. Normally, we're supposed to be paying our pastor. But our pastor refused to collect money. Don't think all the $1 dirty money that you bring is we give it to pastor. We take it to bank. Even sometimes when you get to the bank, the person that wants to take money will look at you. Oh, is it a church money? Yes, it's church money. They already know. They know church money. God will help us. If you have been doing that, change. You need to change. Take that, your $1 that you can take it to bank. They will give you another one. Instead of you giving it to God. God loves a cheerful giver. Give with all your heart. Let it come from your heart. Let it come from your heart. Christian, trying to bring other Christians down. There are some months ago, it was on social media when one musician was trying to bring another musician down. But when God will have his way, God just promote the other one that he was trying to bring down. That's how God works. And there is one song that woman sings. Yahoo alone, blah, blah, blah. That you was singing like it was praising Yahoo. When they asked, I said, why are you singing to praise Yahoo? He said, no, I'm not praising Yahoo. I was just saying that if you praise God, if you Yahoo God, I don't know how you can Yahoo God. He said, there was one time he do 50 days praise. That 50 days praise was Yahoo. That when you praise God, He will bless you. Even after that praise, if you don't even praise Him anymore, the little that you get is enough. Let's open our Bible to the book of John, chapter 4. I'm running out of time. You give me time. Yosha will not give me time. You see, I wrote him, he's standing on my right side. He's already looking at me. Hey, as a more, you need to be getting ready. You say you give me time. By the time I will look back now, you will see Bravenga waving his hand. You have 5 minutes. You have 5 minutes to go. John chapter 4, verse 23. John chapter 4. But the hour has come now when the true worshippers shall worship Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seek sought to worship. God is a spirit, and they that worship must worship Him in spirit and truth. The Bible does not tell me that you have to worship God in Yahoo. We have a lot of Yahoo Christians. You Yahoo Christian because you are looking for a child. The moment the Lord bless you, we don't see you again. You Yahoo God because you are looking for a job. The moment you get the job, you will not come to church again. You Yahoo God because you are looking for paper. The moment you get your paper, you will change your number. The church will not know your number anymore. God is not looking for a crowd. You have to worship God in truth. Worship him from your heart. That's what the Bible says. You cannot deceive God. Do not be deceived. God is no more. Whatever you sow, that's what you're going to reap. I was surprised when the woman was saying that, Yahoo God. I've never known that one. That you have to Yahoo God. So after you get the blessing, you can go. And when you need the blessing again, you come back again and Yahoo God again. You have to be very careful. There are some people that you will invite them to your pulpit to come and sing. And their heart is very far away from God. They were asking this guy, Larry Teriva. You say you have a lot of baby mama. He said, no, I don't like to talk about my family. When people do something wrong, that's the time they would like to cut off. They don't want to go to that area. He said, you have a lot of baby mama. He said, no, I don't want to discuss about that one. Let's talk about my ministry. Okay. He said, okay, what's your ministry? Are you a gospel singer? Because he know that you already asked him about baby mama. Then he told them, I'm not a gospel singer. I'm a gospel entertainer. He's just come and entertain you. And you, when he come and he started singing now, he will say, yeah, Holy Spirit, don't come down. He said, you come and entertain you now. So many gospel singers out there, they are there to come and entertain. He told them, I'm using the gift that God gave me to make money. I have family to feed. I'm not there to sing for someone to be in the spirit. It's online. There is a program they do online, something view. Anything that happens on social media, right there, they put it on, they will call people, ask them questions, how they feel about that, what is going on. Those are the things that we need to be watching, not BB Niger. Christian, we need to wake up. Separate yourself from the crowd. If you have been keeping malice, go to that person. Settle with them. Stop keeping malice. If you are amiable before, stop being amiable. Stop. Don't stop gossiping. Change your ways. There was a time I shared with us here, one of my church in Nigeria. A pastor always criticizes his own pastor. Assistant pastor will be criticizing his own pastor. You don't know how to preach. You're going to preach, the Holy Spirit doesn't move. The assistant doesn't know the pastor would, everything that the assistant was saying, people tell the pastor. You let them know your pastor, as assistant was saying, the man did not get mad. One day he just come to church and say, today, we have a special man of God that will bless us. Spirit feed. Holy Ghost fire. Let's welcome pastor this. When they asked, the man was surprised, the assistant was surprised because they never called him to preach. So now he comes to the pulpit. He doesn't know what to preach. He said, let's open our Bible to the book of Matthew. And Jesus crossed to the boat, you see. Jesus crossed to the boat, you see. Eri. For a good 30 minutes, Jesus crossed to the boat. Eri. You see. Stop criticizing people. We need to change. Change your ways. Let's change our ways. You have to know the son of you are. You can speak in tongues. That's how one brother deceived one sister. Get her pregnant. They were coughing and said, oh, we're going to marry. But the brother cannot wait. See, I cannot buy a car without testing it. Don't let any man test you. If you want to test, tell him to go to dealership. He deceived the sister. He said, nothing. There's nothing going to happen. And the sister believed, if I don't let her test me now, let her go to Jerusalem now, he will leave me. I will not get someone to marry. Don't let devil lie to you. There's a plenty of men outside over there waiting for you. He deceived the sister. After they go to Jerusalem, he told the sister, he said, speak in tongues. The sister speaking in tongues. You see, you are still speaking in tongues. The Holy Spirit is still with you. By the time they know it, the sister gets pregnant. They come to church. The brother left the church. He did not accept the pregnancy. Then the sister becomes single mother. Young one, don't let anyone deceive you. You have chance now. You can hear the word of God. Any brother that says, hey, if you don't let me go to Jerusalem, I will not marry you, let him go. Tell him, go. Go your way. Don't destroy my life. We need to draw closer to God. Don't be far away from him. If you are far away from him, he will be far away from you. When you get home, you can read the book of Romans 16, 17. Hebrews 12, verse 1. 1 Corinthians 2, verse 19. Matthew 13, 36. Matthew 14, verse 13 to 24. Matthew 5, from verse 1 to 48. The book of Mark 8, verse 1 to 11. 2 Corinthians 6, verse 17. You need to stand out. For you to manifest, you have to stand out from the crowd. People will criticize you. People will hate you. Some people will not have anything to do with you anymore. Let them go. Stop the shumale. Get closer to God. The devil that you have been testing, have you seen devil before that you are telling you are teshumale? Let them be deceived. Let people be deceiving you that you step on devil. Is that been stepping on devil? By this time, devil have been supposed to be there right now. Let's get closer to God. Separate yourself from the crowd. God is not looking for crowd. God is looking for a true worshiper who will worship him in truth and in spirit. In truth and in spirit. I want us to rise up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's rise up. Draw me nearer. Near the blessed Lord. Draw me nearer. Near the blessed Lord. To thy precious living time. I want you to know that love, God places a value on you. God places a value on you. No enemy can take your life when you have when you serve him with all your heart. We know the story of Israelites. Because God put value on them. He killed all the firstborn of Egyptians because of them. When you serve God, if a man will please the Lord, he will make his enemy to be at peace with him. Let people run away from you because you are a Christian. It is better. Because when the thing gets worse, they will run away from you. It's better for you to run away from them now. Separate yourself from them. I want you to lift your voice and pray and say, Father, draw me nearer to you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to draw nearer to you. I want to know you more. Daddy, draw me closer to you. If you have been far away from God, I want you to say, Daddy, draw me closer to you. I want to know more of you. I want to get closer to you. Begin to pray and say, Lord, draw me closer to you. Father, Lord, I want to know you more. If there's any area, oh Lord, that I'm not pleasing you, Daddy, I need your help. I need your grace, oh Lord. Draw me closer to you. I know I'm not serving you the way I'm supposed to be serving you, Lord. Daddy, I need your help. Holy Spirit, I need your help. Daddy, I need your help. My Lord and my God, draw me closer to you. Draw me closer to you. Draw me closer to you. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I want you to lift your voice and say, oh Lord, any power that will not let me go, any power that will not allow me to serve you, Father, Lord, let the fire of the Holy Ghost destroy them. Separate me from that power in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth and say, oh Lord, any power that will not allow me to serve you in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever that want to hold me back from serving you, Father, Lord, let the fire of the Holy Ghost destroy them. Daddy, destroy them. Daddy, destroy them. Daddy, destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Lastly, I want you to lift your voice and say, oh Lord, I recover all that the enemy have denied me in this year, in the mighty name of Jesus. What the enemy have denied you, begin to pray that you will recover them all. You will recover them all. You will recover them all in the mighty name of Jesus. I recover all that the enemy has denied me in the mighty name of Jesus. All the benefits you have for me, all the benefits you have prepared for me, all the blessings that you have prepared for me that the enemy have denied me because of sin. Jehovah God, I recover them, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to bless the name of the Lord. Begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.